Asadullah from Canada.
I have one question. I know you probably get hundreds of questions like this, but Sheikh, ever since I started practicing Islam, I get these doubts, like doubts whether or not I sniffed enough water up my nose, or whether or not I washed a certain part of my face or my limb. And another doubt I have is during the Shahud, when I come to the part where we send blessings upon our Prophet, peace be upon him, I doubt whether I even recited the Shahada. So should I just ignore these doubts? Because this is really affecting my ibadah and khushu and salah.
Okay. Wajazak. Asadullah says, since I've started practicing Islam, I get these whispers. Did I turn the water in my mouth and nose or not? Did I do this action or not? Sometimes in prayer, if I am reciting the salutation upon the Prophet ﷺ, I ask myself, did I say the tashahhud before that or not? And this is becoming annoying. So what to do? First of all, if this is reoccurring on daily basis, this is shaitan. Because shaitan is coming to you to make you hesitant whether I did it or not, where most likely you did it. But he's coming there to confuse you, to sadden you, to depress you. And this is what is happening at the moment. You say, why? Before I never had these whispers. Yes, before committing to Islam and practicing it, you were a normal Joy Joe. You had nothing. You're just a normal person. You might have been a servant and a soldier of Satan. I don't know. But you weren't practicing. So what's the point? Now that you're practicing and starting to walk the talk and be on the straight path, now you're posing danger to Shaitan. And this is why when the companions of Ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him, and with his father, came to him complaining that the Jews and Christians mock us Muslims. And they say, you Muslims, whisper in your prayer. You have these evil thoughts, while we, the Jews and the Christians, we have full concentration and submissiveness when we pray. Ibn Abbas said, they're right and truthful in what they say. So his companions were shocked. How is that possible? He said to them, when a burglar wants to break into a house, would he choose the house of a rich man or of a peasant? They said, of a rich man. That's where the beef is. That's where the money is. He said, this is exactly what Shaitan is doing to you. Your hearts are filled with iman. So he needs to confuse you and to give you anxiety attacks. While those, their hearts are so empty, they're filled with shirk, with sins. He doesn't need to do anything. They are one of his teamed members. So it's the same thing with you, Asadullah Azza wa Jal. As long as you have a gut feeling, oh, did I say this or did I do that? Go with it. And usually when you doubt, did I rinse my mouth? Of course you did. You've been doing wudu for how many years? Allah knows. And now you're telling me you forgot to do, this doesn't happen. It's like when you spell your name, you never miss a letter. Asadullah is a long name, I don't know, but usually speaking, you don't miss a letter because this is something you've been doing forever. So move on, akhi, with it.